Do expensive tools really make you a better mechanic? That, of course, is the question of the day. What's up, everybody? It's Charles, and this conversation I see all the time online and in shops, and it comes usually with two different sides. One side is you are an idiot if you buy tools on the tool truck. They're all expensive, overpriced garbage, and they're going to break on you in 5 seconds. Now, as hard as I am on tool trucks, I actually don't, of course, believe that. The flip side is there's no possible way you can be a professional technician if you're using Pittsburgh brand tools or you got some tools at Home Depot Motorsports, which of course is equally as ridiculous. To me, what it all boils down to is, are you getting the car fixed correctly? Because that really, when you boil it down, is the whole point. I like to use this analogy. Let's say you're a golfer and you go out and you play a round of golf with Tiger Woods or whatever the new cool golfer of the day really is, and you're using the most expensive, greatest custom clubs ever built, and Tiger Woods has the cheapest $99 set from your local sporting goods store. Well, I'm gonna almost guarantee you that Tiger Woods would still wipe the floor with you in a round of golf, even though you had the best of the best and he has the worst of the worst. It's his talent, it's his knowledge of the game, it's his experience. Those are so much bigger of a factor than the stick that he's hitting the ball with. Now, give him those high dollar custom clubs and it'll probably do even better, but either way, the clubs aren't what make Tiger Woods an amazing golfer. Does Tiger Woods even play golf anymore? I really don't know, but he was like the jam back in the day. And this is kind of how I see most tool purchases. Let's look at a couple of different categories and start with hand tools. Now, as you guys may or may not know, I really like Snap-on hand tools. I think they make incredible stuff. That being said, for a long time in my career, this exact Craftsman ratchet was my go-to, and I think this cost about $30. Ultimately, they're gonna do about the same job. Now, that changes a little bit when you get into like super high tooth count ratchets or specially designed things, but all in all, you're gonna put a socket on this and you're gonna twist it and it's gonna take off or put on a bolt. So if you find a Pittsburgh ratchet that you are comfortable with and fits your hand and fits in the spaces that you're trying to work, awesome, it's gonna do a great job. Now, if you take a Snap-on socket and let's say a Pittsburgh socket, just for example, that Snap-on socket may fit a little bit better on the bolt. That Snap-on socket may hold the bolt a little bit better rather than drop it all the way down in the deep well. And it may just be a stronger socket, but that Pittsburgh one might also do exactly as good of a job as the Snap-on one does in 99% of the cases. And while quality is very important, your technique for using the ratchet or being able to look at a bolt and how to take it off is going to play as big or bigger of a factor than what socket you're putting on it. Next, let's look at power tools, and this is where we might actually see an advantage to buying that much more expensive one. But it really all depends. For example, I have an electric ratchet from the tool truck. It was very expensive, came with two batteries, and it's great. Good ergonomics, good weight, good power, good speed. I also have one that I bought from Home Depot Motorsports that was half the price. Now, the cheaper one from Home Depot Motorsports is a little less powerful and a little bit slower, but ultimately does the job just as well, to the point where I grab that one rather than the expensive tool truck brand. Now, my pneumatic impact gun, I have an Ingersoll Rand composite gun. I bought this one, I spent more money deliberately because I wanted something composite, so I wanted it light. I also wanted something that was quieter. Yeah, I know, like, Charles, don't be delicate. It gets really loud in the shop when you're running an impact gun right here near your face all day long. And so having that lower decibel level, even though I sacrificed a little power, was worth it to me. Things like ergonomics and battery life and noise level are all key factors when trying to decide what power tool to use. Now, I could have bought that $100 one from Harbor Freight, but to me, it's worth spending a little bit extra money on the pneumatic tool to get something that I felt was more valuable. Power tools are a place where you sometimes do really see the benefit for spending more money. But again, we have to be smart about the tools that we buy and make sure that we're buying what we need for our application. Moving on to diagnostic equipment, this is an area where almost every case it makes sense to buy the more expensive one because you're going to usually get a better tool. Now, if we're talking about a $15 test light, it doesn't matter, right? It's a stick of metal with a spring and a light bulb and a cord and a clamp. there's not too much to it. But what about when we look at things like scan tools? That more expensive one is probably going to do more for us. What about lab scopes? If we're breaking out the lab scope, do we really want to trust these results to a cheap product? Maybe that cheap one doesn't update as fast as the expensive one. Maybe it doesn't have the range that the expensive one does. When it comes to diagnostics, things like multimeters and meter leads, we do not want to trust our very important test to an inferior product. So diagnostic equipment is an area where I think in general, not every time, but in general, buying the more expensive one is usually worth the money. These are also not the first tools we're buying. We're way into our career at the point of we're looking at lab scopes and things like that. Now, what about toolboxes? This is one I'm actually kind of mixed on. I've owned a very expensive Snap-on toolbox, great box, loved it. I've also had some Home Depot Motorsports brand. I've also had some low-level Matco box. The yellow box with all the stickers on it is a Matco box. This is a Milwaukee toolbox parked right here. And this really depends. Ultimately, they all hold tools pretty much the same. So you can make a really good case of buy the one that fits your space, regardless of if it's Home Depot Motorsports, Milwaukee, Husky, whatever, or if it's the really high dollar Snap-on one. Consider though, if you're opening and closing those drawers all day long, do you want something that the drawer wobbles around every time and feels like it's gonna fall out, or do you want something solid? You know, as I say this, I think I'm gonna save all the toolbox stuff for a separate video because there's a lot that we can get into with toolboxes, and we can go as cheap as $250 or as expensive as I think $12,000, which was retail on the box, Snap-on box that I had, which I didn't pay anywhere near that, but I know a lot of people do. Finally, let's finish up with specialty equipment. This is gonna be, you know, timing tools and that kind of stuff. Here, it may not matter at all, and it may really, really matter, or you might not have a choice. If you're looking for a certain specialty tool, and there's two companies that make it, they're probably gonna be about the same price. That being said, let's say you're looking for some timing tools, you might be able to find that setup on Amazon for $50, where if you bought it from like Assenmacher or something like that, it's going to be $150 to $200. The quality might be better on the more expensive one, but if it's something you're gonna use once or twice, do you really need that high dollar one? All things, of course, to consider with each and every tool purchase. Ultimately, to me, it boils down to, do you have the skills, the knowledge, the talent? Are you a good mechanic, or are you a good technician, or are you not? If you're not a good technician, buying high-end, high-dollar tools are not going to make you a good technician. Experience, talent, knowledge, those are the things that are going to make you a good technician or a better technician. If you're a good technician, will buying a high-dollar ratchet make you better? Maybe, probably not better, but it might make you more efficient. It might allow you to do a job a little bit faster, and that can make you a more efficient technician. But to me, it really boils down to your talent, your skill, your knowledge, just like the Tiger Woods Golf Club story. It's all about what's in here and how it gets to here, more so than what you're holding in your hand while you're taking a part off or putting a part on. With that, I'm gonna leave you with a question of the day. Do you think expensive tools make you a better technician or a better mechanic? Drop your comments down below. Guys, thank you so much for watching, and I'll talk to you again next time.